Well, I guess we'll go to this Tecunis then. New system. So I'll be looking at the planets and, you know, reading about them and stuff. You know the drill.
Tecunis. Why does that sound familiar?
It does sound familiar.
They named it after the Tecunis expedition, the first Solarians to reach the Citadel.
Hmm.
It's a big name to live up to.
I see.
Anomaly on sensors.
Well, that's our track here. Before we do anything, let's look at these planets. Got the outermost one, Slova. Is that the trail from the shuttle? Damn. Or is that a flare from the sun? Slova. Despite its ferocious heat and thick methane-rich atmosphere, Slova might have been capable of supporting microbial life millions of years ago. Yeah, nothing.
Anomaly on sensors.
Yep. We'll go to H523. After we finish checking out these planets, we'll look at the shuttle's trail. H523 appears to have been a rogue planet captured by Tecunis's gravity and brought into an unusual orbit around the star. Long-term study of its composition may reveal more of its origins. Well, our study's not going to help.
Anomaly detected.
Motifs? I don't know how to say that. The outermost of Tecunis's three sibling worlds, Mosives, is a mountainous planet of lime and potassium. I guess we can't get any of this potassium. Either that or we don't want it.
Anomaly detected.
Mosiba.
Anomaly detected.
One of three rocky planets named for the Stones of Life of an ancient Solarian religion, Mosiba is the smallest and hottest of the triad. And there's something here.
Probe away. Tracking a huge mineral deposit.
Cool. Beryllium. Retake. Got 50 of that.
Anomaly detected.
Indeed. Vinvaco. Still missed the longer planet descriptions from Mass Effect 1, 2, and 3. Is that the shuttle itself at the end there? Ooh, cool looking. Light side and dark side.
I'm picking up something.
Easier to read from the dark side. The hydrogen and helium atmosphere of this gas giant has been slowly stripped away over hundreds of millions of years. Consumed by the Tecunis sun, given time it may be reduced to a terrestrial world. Very small area here.
Deploying probe. Satellite detected.
Hmm. Satellite ID unknown. Power readings 83.2%. System report, severe damage to broadcast array. Status active. A scientific monitoring satellite. It is no longer transmitting its findings and appears to have been damaged by a gradual descent into the gas giant's atmosphere. Hmm. I got Milky Way research data. Okay. Oh, that is flaring. Hold on, I'm trying to... This goes the opposite way than you think it would. Yeah, we can't see anything. I'm trying to, like, follow that trail. Hmm.
I'm picking up something.
One more planet to look at. Mosino. Everything is Mos. Well, not everything, but... So many. So many Mos. Mos Eisley Spaceport. Hmm. The largest of the three sibling worlds of the Tecunis system, Mosino has a hot surface and extremely thin atmosphere composed of methane and argon.
Anomaly on sensors.
Okay, now... we'll check out this anomaly.
Probes launched. Sam sent me the data on that shuttle. I've set up our scanners to track it. Just say the word.
Hmm. Radiation trail. Yeah, I don't skip the animations the first time, guys. Of these little voyages. But with repeat...
This radiation trail matches the shuttle we're tracking.
With repeat occurrences, I will. Tracking Nexus shuttle stolen by Ruth Bekker. Signature consistent with expected readings based on engineer's account of damage to shuttle. Logging data to facilitate tracking. We got Milky Way research data. Now what? Follow that trail.
Anomaly detected.
Boop.
Probes launched. Anomaly found.
Comet Tomoko's arrow. There seems to be a lot less scourge here. Hmm. Platinum deposit. The orbit of this star grazer has persisted despite the scourge and other hazards. Likely it will withstand even a significant attempt to mine its core elements. I got 31 platinum. I don't know what that has to do with the shuttle. Guess nothing. Where now? Do we want to leave the system? Contagion. I'm not going to Aladdin yet. Wait. I'm guessing, yeah, this is Zaubray. This is where we want to go. Okay. We'll go there. Not landing on Aladdin yet or any of that stuff.
Careful. Word is there's pirates all over this region.
You'd think they'd run out of people to steal from. I'm picking up something.
Okay. Is it there? I'm gonna look at everything but Aladdin. I'm not gonna even look at it. You know, I think I will actually, but first. H315. Just definitely not landing there. Actually pretty. H315's day is long enough and its atmosphere thin enough that its temperature can plummet at night. It's at either extreme, it should be considered hazardous.
I'm picking up something.
Alright, just gonna look at this. Aladdin. Or Eladin. Cool. A moistureless, sweltering landscape covered by a large number of cover subsidence sinkholes, Eladin still supports life to a limited degree. The fledgling Krogan colony of New Tuchanka is here, along with what appears to be abandoned mining facilities, scattered outposts, and camps. Yeah, not landing.
Something.
I'm picking up a Grogorna. I guess those others are moons? Cool, look at the rings. Looks like molten.
Anomaly on sensors.
The radiation of the Zaubray sun keeps much of Gorgona molten at all times. Oceans of magma thwart all but the fiercest attempts at exploration.
Deploying probe. Tracking a huge mineral deposit.
Cool. Copper. 97 copper. Sweet. Yeah, nothing else.
Something.
So we got Dubrassi left. Dubrassi High. I guess this is like a Star Trek The Next Generation shuttle capable of a small amount of warp speed or something.
I'm picking up something.
Dubrassi's nickel and cobalt surface defies the planet's intense heat to remain solid. Trace readings of element zero are present, but difficult to pinpoint.
Probes launched. Anomaly found.
Crevice. Length 329 kilometers. Average width, 6 kilometers. Maximum height, 6 kilometers. This narrow canyon is startlingly deep. A river of magma rich with minerals runs at the base, and alien technology, possibly old Angaran facilities, lines the walls. This must be the source of the planet's element zero. Experience, huh? Not element zero? Okay.
Anomaly on sensors.
Okay, that's it for the planets. Check out the anomaly, which is this little twinkle. I figured it was.
Deploying probe. deploying probe. I found something.
I found something. A radiation trail. Yeah, research data.
Radiation is a match. She went this way, all right.
Signature match for Nexus shuttle stolen by Ruth Bekker. Hull integrity degrading. Milky Way research data. How has she passed through all these systems?
I'm picking up something. Probe away.
We'll be finding her soon.
Tracking a huge mineral deposit.
That's a mineral deposit. How many systems does she go to? Yeah, see, those are all moons. M-type asteroid. This ultra-dense asteroid contains a carbonaceous buildup around a metal core composed of an unknown alloy. It's highly likely it was part of an artificial structure centuries ago. Remnant technology of something entirely new. 87 graphite. Alright, that's it for this system. Now going to Anasa? We'll check out that one next. How many systems? Like, your hull integrity is, like, very bad. How can you-
Radio emissions from the black hole are incredible out here.
Oh, wow.
The song of the dark side of creation.
That's beautiful. How-
I'm picking up something.
Sure you are. How could she go so far with a hull integrity degrading in a shuttle? It's not a starship, it's a shuttle. H205. Let's go there. Check out all these planets. This little guy. Oh, looks big now. A diminutive sphere of rock and ice, H205, is entirely unmapped and is not universally shown on Helios cluster charts. It could one day prove an excellent hiding place. Oh, some contagion person on our shuttle? Well, if there's no one else here, then that would be fine.
Anomaly on sensors.
I'm betting it's that thing. Let's check out Mornax Vinkar, though. It appeared for a second. A Turian exile attempted to found a trading post on one of the gas giant's minuscule moons. This project ended in disaster. Mornax Vinkar is a Turian phrase for bad mistake. Okay.
I'm picking up something.
So these planets do already have a history. Some of them is just a very short history. Compared to the planets in Mass Effect 1, 2, and 3, that's had a history behind them. I mean, they could go into more detail, but eh. Acermos. The Collective appears to be using Acermos as a listening post. Several unmanned receiver stations dot the planet, either studying the black hole or monitoring local ship traffic. Yeah, I wish we could, like, destroy them. That'd be cool. Do not listen to people. Very bad.
Anomaly on sensors.
Two more planets. H-444. A few uncharacteristic gouges in the planet's surface suggest a group of exiles has been here, stripping away easily accessed mineral deposits. I guess they left nothing for us. Way to go. Nice. Thanks for sharing.
Anomaly on sensors.
One more planet, Sedeli. Despite its comfortable temperature and seas of liquid water, Sedeli is heavily irradiated by mass ejections from the system's sun and is therefore unsuitable for colonization. But we have found...
probes launched.
The following.
Getting a scan.
A river. Source is a spring. Composition liquid water. Length, many kilometers. Colonies of jellyfish-like creatures move freely along this enormous river, despite the lack of life elsewhere on the planet. The river may be the last remnant of a dying ecosystem. Some XP. Down by the river.
Anomaly detected.
Okay, and it's this thing right there. Bloop.
Deploying probe. Getting a scan.
Let's check it out. How much further can she go? Crazy.
Radiation trail is consistent with previous scans. This is our shuttle.
Shuttle systems were failing. Hull integrity nearing critical. More research data. But she can still go to another system, even though her hull integrity is critical. That's not what I meant to hit.
Anomaly detected.
Yeah, I was wondering about that one.
Probe away. I found something.
Starship wreckage. I'm guessing this has nothing to do with the shuttle? All that particulate matter. Ship identity and name unknown. Crew complement unknown. Estimate 5 to 8. Status not available. This appears to be the remnants of a cat, scout, or dropship. Enough functional parts remain to suggest it was not destroyed by Nexus exiles. Perhaps the Rokar were responsible? Got a bunch of stuff. Alright, let me guess, we have to go to another system. Yep. So she made it all the way up here. You know how far this must be? It must be capable of faster than light travel. Okay, so off to the Solminae cluster. Another one we haven't visited, explored, stuff. Time and relative dimension and space.
With all this travel, we're building up a bigger picture of the Scourge. I wonder if it's just local to Helios, or if all Andromeda's like this?
It's a very good question.
Anomaly detected.
This is a big system. Let's check out H-148. I can't believe she can get this far. Can't get over that. That paranoid running away and destroying her hull. Great mountain ranges of frozen carbon dioxide cover the gloomy surface of H-148, trapping deposits of gold and aluminum underneath.
Anomaly detected.
Next one is this one. Suriko.
Sensors.
Centuries ago, Angaran explorers set out beyond their space to Suriko, which they believe might be habitable. The colony didn't last, but it has strong symbolic significance nonetheless. Oh, this thing? It's in orbit.
Probe away. Getting a scan.
Ooh, more starship wreckage. Ship identity, name, crew complement all unknown. The wreck of a Rokar vessel drifts above Suriko. It appears to have been abandoned. Got Helios research data. And it looks like that. Pretty cool. I love the flashing of like electrical shorting out and all that. Pretty cool. Okay, that's it for that.
Anomaly detected.
Okay, next, moving our way in towards the sun, Avalosa. Wingardium Avalosa. It's Wingardium Avalosa, not Avalosar. It's totally barbaric. Did I see another thing in orbit? So a little twinkle.
Anomaly on sensors.
There's a twinkle right there. Given its size and position, Avalosa might once have been a moon of H-323, though how it was displaced is unclear. Unusual radiation emissions make Avalosa difficult to scan, but yet scan it we will.
Probes launched. Satellite detected.
Cool. Satellite ID, Nexus 0105-L. Power readings 91.2%. System report, communications functional and active. Status, operational. This appears to be a Nexus satellite stolen and reprogrammed by the Collective. It is actively monitoring this planet Suriko. Let's take it back. What we can do is get research data from it. Mm. Alright. Kind of disappointed we can't do anything about these things. That
anomaly on sensors.
That have been taken from us. I'd love to just take them back. Next is H-323. Well, that's the one that the other planet mentioned. There might be a moon of it or something. Kind of hope this is the last system we have to go on this wild goose chase. When I get there, trying to have us explore the galaxy. I would do it anyway. This frigid desert world appears to have once been covered in plant life. It was reduced to its current state millions of years ago, long before the scourge, by the aging sun.
Anomaly detected.
Okay, last planet. Ooh, Red Choraic? Interesting name. Let me guess, it's red because it's molten. Yeah, it almost looks like a sun itself. Brutal temperatures, noxious gases, crushing atmospheric pressure, and constant tectonic upheavals earned this world the name of legendary Milky Way pirate Red Korak. That's one hell of a name.
Anomaly on sensors.
Okay, so now I've explored it all. Let me guess, is this the anomaly?
Probe away.
Getting good at this.
Getting a scan.
Let's see now. The place is in like, the shuttle's in like 12 different pieces, but it's still traveling to the next solar system. Man, they make these shuttles good these days.
Pathfinder, scans confirm the damaged shuttle trail leads to a landing site on Kadara's surface.
Kadara's surface? Hull integrity critical. Shuttle destruction imminent at this point. So we're still able to get to another solar system to go to Kadara. How does this make any sense at all? Oh, I keep doing that.
Anomaly on sensors.
This thing?
Probes launched. I found something.
You found starship wreckage. So what are we doing now? Going back to Kadara? We did find a lot of shuttle wreckage on Kadara for some reason. All of it was Turian that we found.
We're here, Ryder. That point where the three Sabers supposedly attacked a supply ship.
Oh, yeah,
I'm
yeah.
I'm getting a unique radiation signature from the scans. I think their drive's leaking ESO.
Does it lead anywhere?
I'm only getting a general vector. If we scan the other sites, we could narrow it down.
Ship identity, Nexus 29-17. Ship name, Bourbon Sally. Crew complement of 2. Status, partially destroyed, salvageable. A small scouting ship sent to investigate a portion of the Scourge. It was lost shortly after leaving the Nexus. It was assumed that contact with the Scourge brought her down. Analysis of the wreckage makes it abundantly clear that the ship was attacked. I got a bunch of goodies. Cool. Okay, that's it. So it started here, I think, Tecunis, and then went to Zaubray. Anasa, Salmi, and Gavorkum. That's crazy. In a shuttle. That was deteriorating, like, very early on. I don't want to go back to Kadara. We do have something else to do in Kadara, don't we? T. Find the shuttle in Kadara. Someone wants to go down there, don't they? Collect the Remtech PB needs. Huh. She wants to go to Aya. Cat devices. Oh, we're done. Next time we go back to the Nexus, we can talk to Dr. Aradana, because we got way over 50 planet scans that she needed. So she should be happy. I need to talk to Carrie Tavessa again? Okay. We have two things to go back to the Nexus for now. Beer from bootleggers at Kadara Port. Alright. Well, I'm gonna think about it. We've got little things to do. Oh, look. Cool, look at my shadow. Whoop. 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 We've got, like, one thing to do on Aya. We've got two things to do on Kadara. We've got two or three things to do on the Nexus. I don't know. I might just bang those out before we continue back to Eos. And hopefully we can explore everything on Eos. Thanks so much for watching, guys. See you in the next episode. And endure. And enduring, grow strong.